There are many roads to the Stanley Cup, but all are grounded in the simple truth that no man wins it alone. Each championship team has its own character, building a bond of brotherhood and shared sacrifice that lasts a lifetime. In 1974, the path to victory was a gauntlet of fists and fury.
I believe a team has to have a personality, whatever it is. Canadians had one, the Flying Frenchman, and then there was the Big Bad Bruins, and those were days where you could have a personality and use it to beat your opponent.
We were a tough, hard-nosed team. Nothing wrong with that. A lot of people loved the way we played. And of course, a lot of them didn't like us at all.
We started physically going after teams. We were tired of getting beat up. And when we started beating them up, there was a lot of whining going on. They didn't like us then. They liked us better when we were small and getting the crap beat out of us.
They knew they were going to get their money's worth when they came to see the Broad Street Bullies play. I remember one time in particular, we're in L.A., and the headlines, the L.A. Times, the animals are loose. Lock your doors.
Schultz is hammering Dunn with that right hand. And all Dunn is able to do is hang on at the moment. He's trying to get...
I didn't see it as violence at all. It was hockey that was being played at the time, and the referees were in charge of controlling it. And we were penalized a lot for it, rightfully so, but we still won hockey games.
The 1974 final was billed as a heavyweight brawl, and it well earned that description. Bobby Clark's Broad Street Bullies against Bobby Orr's Big Bad Bruins.
As the series was very close, I remember we lost the first game in Boston. We lost 3-2. Orr shot the puck off my foot with about 30 seconds to go, and they win the game. The second game, we were down 2-1 with a minute to go, and Ricky McLeish makes a pass out to Moose DuPont, and he ties it up, and then we go into overtime, and Clark scores in overtime.
Schultz behind the net, centers, flat, tries to Clark, shot, oh, rebound, score! Bobby Clark scores!
That's when we really had an idea we can beat this team. And then the next two games were in Philadelphia.
So my philosophy was always us and 18,000 people against the opposite team. And once you have, you know, a vision like this, it's very difficult to lose a game.
I remember laying in bed that night thinking to myself, my gosh, if we win tomorrow, we win the friggin' Stanley Cup. This is what I dreamt about my entire life.
The morning of Game 6, Fred Shearer left a message on the board that would define the rest of their lives.
Deadline came, put your mask on, your gloves, have your stick, and then you march on onto the ice. And never forget this, you look at the players, and then you step on the ice, and the crowd is going crazy. God bless her. You know, I thought the roof was going to come down. You know, that was so powerful, so beautiful. Once she got done singing, the fans were pumped. You know, as a player, you're pumped.
I had no fear of playing the Boston Bruins. I had a huge fear of getting beat. It wasn't a physical fear, but it was a motivating fear, so you play the best you possibly can play.
Perron was perfect for 59 minutes and 50 seconds. The Flyers led 1-0, but the greatest player of that generation had the puck.
There was about 10 seconds left. Bobby Orr gets it, shoots it down the ice. I'm looking at the clock at the same time. Never saw it. By the time I saw it, it was too late. If we hit the net, hit the net would have been in.
The Flyers are going to win the Stanley Cup! Flyers win the Stanley Cup! The Flyers are going to win the Stanley Cup! Oh!
I wouldn't have the vocabulary or the brains to come up with how you're feeling and thinking. At that time, there's such relief and such ecstasy that you just don't know what to do with yourself.
To have my name on the Stanley Cup, which means that as a team, you know, you're the champions that year, the best hockey team in the world. Wow. You know, every time you think about this, it's just as exciting as when we won. Isn't that good? The next day, I wasn't sure we had won the cup. So I opened the front door. The newspaper was there. It said on the front page, the Flyers won the Stanley Cup. Yeah.
E-M-C-R-O-H-U-L-L.
M-E-S-S-G-R-E-T-Z-K-Y.
F-E-D-O-U-R-K-E-I-T-O.
R-O-Y-Z-B-R-O-R-R.
They said that after the first one was a fluke. They said that after the second one. If we win the third, they'll say it's a fluke again.
And he's got a tough opponent.
In 1976, the NHL was at a crossroads.
Left and right, left and right, they're up.
The Flyers proved that toughness was the new currency for championships.
Philadelphia got a way to win. I never see a team ready before a game like this. Everybody was ready to fight. Everybody was ready to play tough. But we knew if they want to play tough, we have the guys.
Under Scotty Bowman, Montreal found a way to compete and continue their winning tradition. With a new generation of future Hall of Famers, including Bob Gainey, Larry Robinson, Ken Dryden, and the Flower, Guy Lafleur.
Playing the Flyers was, I wouldn't say was not easy, was tough. They were big, they could fight.
We wanted to beat the Flyers for a couple of reasons. One, the Flyers had won two straight cups, which meant that the Canadians had lost two straight cups. And the other part was, I didn't like the Flyers.
That one was my favorite. The Flyers were at their peak, and we felt that we had a lot of pressure throughout the league to kind of change the way that people thought that the game should be played.
All the team was cheering for us. Because if we were to lose, all the team would try to be like they were. Big and tough.
Oh, it was harsh. We had a strong rivalry because we were both intense competitive teams, each of us willing to pay a big price to get to the prize.
3 seconds, 2 seconds. The game is over, and the Montreal Canadiens defeat Philadelphia 4 consecutive games with 1 second
apiece. We win the game. We win the fight, we win everything.
We've won the Stanley Cup now, and this is just really an extraordinary team. By far the best team that I've ever played on, and really all over the ice. The defense played well, the forwards played well, both offensively and defensively. I've never had as much fun playing with a team as I have with this team.
You know, you have to play as a team, and the team has to be a big family, and they have to go to war together, and you have to stick together as a unit. And that's what the team was doing at the time.
You have to work so hard to get there, but you had to work much harder to stay with the Montreal Canadiens because they're a team who win all the time. And you want to keep the tradition going.
When you talk about Montreal, when they go 3 years without winning it, it's a bit of a drought.
That's what it was like playing in Montreal. I think it drove you to be a better player, because anything less than the Stanley Cup